We have studied the concept of simple interest. So now let us solve a very simple sum in order to strengthen our understanding. The sum says that Ria borrows a sum for rupees 5,000. So this is the amount of money that she is borrowing. And she pays a total amount of rupees 5,500 after 2 years. So we have to find the rate of interest. Or in other words, we have to calculate R. Now over here, what are the things that we have been given? We have been given that the principal is equal to rupees 5,000 because that is the money that Ria is borrowing. We have also been given the total amount that Ria is returning after a period of 2 years. So that is the amount. The amount is rupees 5,500. And the time for which she is borrowing the money is 2 years. So these are what we have been given. So over here we see that A is rupees 5,500 and P is rupees 5,000. Now, if you recall our previous discussion, you will remember that amount, that is A, is nothing but the principal, that is P, plus the extra amount of money that needs to be paid in order to be able to borrow this P. And that is the simple interest I. Thus, amount is equal to principal plus the simple interest. So over here, amount is 5,500. The principal is 5,000. And we have to calculate the interest. So if I simply rearrange this equation, I will be able to calculate the value of interest. That will be 5,500 minus 5,000, giving me the interest. That is nothing but rupees 500, which comes out to be the interest or the additional amount of money that Ria will have to pay. So the interest is rupees 500. Now that we have calculated the interest, let us proceed to calculate the rate of interest. So we have that interest is equal to rupees 500. Now, if you recall our previous discussion, you will remember that the formula for simple interest is P into R into T divided by 100, where P is the principal, R is the rate of interest, and T is the time for which the money is being borrowed. So now we simply substitute the values for P and T as well as I, because we need to find out the value of R. So substituting the value of I get rupees 500 equal to, I substitute the value for P, that is 5,000, into R, R is still unknown to us, into T, that is 2 years. So this is the equation that I get. Now I can further simplify this equation because the value I'm interested to find is R. So if I simply cross multiply, I will get R as 500 into 100 divided by 5,000 into 2 divided by 5,000 into 2. So this is the rearranged equation for calculating the value of R. So now I can simplify this equation by cancelling 3 zeros from the denominator and 3 zeros from the numerator. So I'm left with 50 divided by 10. That is nothing but 5%. So 5% is the rate of interest at which Ria is borrowing the money, rupees 5,000, for a total of 2 years. And the amount of money, as had been given by the sum, which she is paying back, is nothing but the principal plus the simple interest that is equal to rupees 5,500. So we found that if I, P and T are known, then we can easily calculate the value of R. And not only that, if any three values are known to us, then we can calculate the fourth one. Likewise, we know that amount is equal to principal plus interest. Even in that case, if either of two values out of all these three are known, we can calculate the third value. And knowing the third value, we can use it to find out any particular value we might be needing from this equation.